The acting premier admits the youth justice laws have failed, but warns there's no silver bullet solution. There's mounting public and political pressure on the government to get tough after last week's Alexandra Hills tragedy.
2:20 this morning, northbound on the M1. Watch on the right as a stolen BMW races by and moments later crashes with a sedan and rolls. A 56-year-old man was injured, a 14-year-old boy, 17-year-old youth and 16-year-old girl were charged with a number of offences, fueling growing calls for the youth justice laws to be beefed up.
Well, look, clearly there have been failings, but in the past week or so there have been some incidents that frankly shouldn't have happened.
The acting premier says the government will take the advice of Police Commissioner Katerina Carroll, who expressed frustration and wants the laws reviewed after the deaths of Kate Ledbetter, Maddie Field and their unborn son, Miles.
No simple answer here. There's no silver bullet.
This is about stealing cars, committing armed robberies. These are serious offences, which if you committed as an adult, you would be serving many, many years in an adult correctional centre.
New Minister Leanne Lynard was sent to the youth crime hotspot Townsville to pacify local anger 2 days after six teenagers were arrested after a stolen Land Cruiser sped through red lights, narrowly missing members of the public, injuring several officers.
Absolutely appalling. This sort of behaviour, we expect people who engage in this sort of behaviour to be held to account.
Willing to look at changes.
The mandatory sentencing does not work, but, you know, we'll look at any suggestions.
Deputy Commissioner Paul Taylor said there have been 11 cases of stolen vehicles in a week involving 18 children. Six were on bail.
If you're a guardian of a young person, show the love before the tragedy. Take an interest in where your kid is.
Lane Calcutt, Nine News.